car, you're going to be judged anyway. So, you know, do your talking on the field, which is what I've said for 2 years. I didn't say it exactly like that, but I've been saying for 2 years, I was mad that Cap didn't get the money before doing this. Right. And when it comes to protesting, you do it when you're led and how you're led to do it. You can't do it, okay, I'm going to make this stance in 4 years. It didn't work that way. He was propelled to do something, and he did it. I get it. But what he's doing is costing him. It's what has costed him his career.
Right.
And that's all I want people to understand.
Right. Here's the thing. I think that people, myself included, feel like the narrative surrounding Colin Kaepernick is all fucked up.
Okay.
He shouldn't have to apologize for speaking the truth and protesting something that's right.
He shouldn't have to apologize for protesting, period.
He shouldn't have to compromise his ethics and morals when he is right.
I agree.
And the fact that Ray Lewis, this public figure, gets behind a microphone and throws him under the bus is just a bad look for niggas, period.
Okay. But how did Ray throw him under the bus? That's what I disagree with. What did Ray say and or do that is throwing Kaepernick under the bus?
He's saying too much. He's saying that he should focus on football. Why should he focus just on football? He shouldn't have
career?
A life outside
Don't
of that.
Don't you focus on your career?
Right, but listen. Here's the thing about
Can't
it,
answer
though.
The question, though. Don't you focus on your career?
True.
Okay.
But I think at the end of the day, it's the fact that you go public.
I'm not
with
mixing
this.
No goddamn words. Keep it coming. Keep asking me the questions. I'll make every point. I'm not mixing no words.
The fact is, you as a black person, especially Ray Lewis, has been in a lot of shit in his life. Should
right.
understand
uh-huh.
where Colin Kaepernick is coming from. Once again, if you don't have nothing safe to, or good to say to support this guy, mm-hmm. just don't say nothing at all.
But I don't think he
because
said
he comes across looking like a coon.
I don't think he said anything that didn't support Colin Kaepernick, other than him saying, "You gotta do your talking on the field. You gotta." He didn't say cut your hair. He's just saying, you're going to be judged anyway. I'm not against you. I love you. I pray for you. My name is in your Bible. Oh, my God. My name is in your Bible. What's so bad that Ray said to this kid or about this kid? He told this kid to get a job. He's telling this kid to when you get on the field, let your play do the talking for you. That's how you sustain a career in this league. That's what he told the kid.
But, Ryan, that's bullshit.
Okay.
This man has proven on the field that he can play. The whole
But he's not playing now, Doug. He's not in the league now.
So, and here's another issue I think people have. And this is your show. I don't want to feel like I'm taking over.
Let's go.
The other problem with this is that if you look at the players, if you look at players in the past in NFL history and sports history that have gotten into real trouble, this has never been an issue.
Right.
This has never been an issue that you're going to be such a bad person as far as us in sales and selling tickets that we're not going to give you a job. Greg Hardy's gotten jobs. I mean, Lawrence Phillips got jobs. What Colin Kaepernick is doing is so bad that you ignore the history of the NFL giving guys second, third, fourth opportunities, but we don't want to give you a job. And Ray Lewis, he may not be doing it purposely, consciously, mm-hmm. but on the outside it looks like he is coming down. He's a detractor.
So here's my point, man, and I guess this is what I'm missing, man. All of a sudden, behind Colin Kaepernick and his protest, or him not standing during the anthem or not saluting the flag, all of a sudden, black people have forgotten that black and white still exist in this world?
No.
Okay, so the people that can give Kaepernick a job don't look like Kaepernick.
Right, we understand that.
Okay, as much as Ozzie can do what he wants to do and make the decisions he wants to make. But if Bachetti says you can't do this or you should do that, he can't pull the trigger. So all of a sudden now, everybody wants all these athletes that make their money from these white people that own this corporation. You want me to shit on them. That's what you want me to do.
How is he shitting on them by protesting social injustice?
No. You want, I'm not, here's one of the things I wanted to say today.
And you're listening to The Ryan Stewart Show.
It's easy for folks to say what you should or shouldn't do. I keep hearing, these athletes should do this. This athlete should do that. How come this person won't take a stand with him? These people have lives to provide for too, Doug.
Right, I understand that.
And what everybody's saying, and I just did not hear the venom that people are getting from Ray Lewis's words to Kaepernick. I don't get any venom in any of those words. I don't get coon in those words.
Right, here's the thing about it. And I'm going to move on from this. We got to move on. There's a couple more things we got
to
talk about.
Oh, we can stay. Oh, we can stay.
Okay, and you're listening to the Ryan Stewart Show. I think at the end of the day, and I said it earlier, but let me just say it in much simpler words. I think at the end of the day, people feel like when you come out in the open behind a microphone and you say something negative towards what this guy is doing, whether it's true or not, it's perceived to be like you're coming down on this guy. It's a bad. It makes it look like you're trying to dance for the establishment, like you're trying to be the corporate guy. Like you're trying to say these things just to appease the masses. I think at the end of the day, that's the real problem. I've actually said it on my show too. I think Ray had good intentions, but at the end of the day, when you come out against a guy that's had such an important, impactful protest like this, it sounds like you dancing for massa.
That's fine. Can you tell me, and I didn't hear every comment. I didn't read every article. I could give a damn to do so. But can you tell me what Ray Lewis said to or about Kaepernick that was negative? The word you just used was negative. So I'm not asking what anybody in the chat room saying. No. I want you to tell me what was negatively said about Kaepernick or to Kaepernick by Ray Lewis.
No, once again, I said it before. The words that he spoke at the end of the day.
Tell me what they were, Doug. I'm not word playing with you. Just answer the question.
Well, we've heard exactly what he said.
I'm asking you what was negative, though. You tell me in your words.
Hold on. I said it 5 minutes ago. At the end of the day, I understand what he was trying to say. I just don't think that he should have done it in for public consumption. And it looks like it gives the appearance that he's trying to dance for the masses.
But you still ain't telling me what he danced for master by saying,
no,
Doug.
I just told you.
No, you didn't.
I asked you
a direct question. You're not answering the question.
To not protest. That's what he said. In effect, he telling Colin Kaepernick
not, in effect,
not
Doug.
To protest.
Not in effect, Doug. I don't want in effect.
Ryan, I don't have a quote in front of me in as many words.
But that's the point I want to make right there. The fact that you don't have a quote, but you're so irate about something that was negatively said from Ray Lewis.
Ryan, I talk about this every day, 3 hours a day. I don't have a quote in front of me.
If he
Ray Lewis has insinuated, has said out loud that Colin Kaepernick should keep his protest to himself.
Right. And Doug, if he kept this protest to himself, he would have a job right now. He would.
Yeah, but then black people still be getting shot in the back five times running away from the police.
That's not going to change because black people have been shot since then. I don't want to hear that. What Cap did is not why black people are being shot or not being shot.
That may not change, but to speak out against it, an obvious truth,
he didn't speak
it
out.
Can't be wrong.
I don't see it as him speaking out against him protesting, Doug. I see it as a man that knows this guy has the ability to be in the league, and he's saying, well, here's what you did and why you're not in the league. That's all I'm saying. Yeah, I mean, it's easy for you to say what somebody else should say. I see the whole coon aspect behind what Michael Vick said. And that's why Vick was backpedaling and mixing words and changing stories. I get it. He told that boy to cut his hair. That was dumb. That was coonish. Ray didn't say nothing disrespectful or negative about him protesting. He's saying, well, dude, the reason why you're not in the field is because of what's going on with the situation. And that's the truth.
Yeah.
That's the truth.
I just think it's a very bad look. And especially coming from somebody like Ray Lewis.
I get it, man.
Who a lot of people, especially in this city, feel like got away with murder. I don't think that Ray Lewis killed those people at the Super Bowl here in Buckhead in Atlanta.
The odds that he did are slim to none, but he has something to do with it. Yes. Yeah.
It appears not only is it bad that you bring out and air out this dirty laundry to a degree and saying that the man shouldn't protest social injustice in this country. Not only that, but you have a record that's very, very shoddy at best.
We all have to live with the decisions that we make as individuals. We have to live with the decisions. If we're convicted about something and it's to the point where we decide to take a stand, then we have to deal with that conviction because it's in our heart. It's what we want to do. Ray didn't bash Colin Kaepernick.
Do you believe
he didn't say you're wrong for protesting. He didn't say you're wrong for standing up against the injustices of people that look like you. He didn't say that.
And you're listening to the Ryan Stewart Show on the Two Live Shoes Radio
Network.
Why
are we acting like that's not why he's not playing? But that's because that's why he's not playing. Why are we acting like that? You're not surprised about him not having a job because of what he's done?
I am very surprised.
Oh, man.
I talked about it on my show today. When he started doing this last year, I can't believe anything other than when he started to do this, he never thought in a million years that he wouldn't be able to get a job for trying to bring attention to some bullshit going on in this country.
I understand and I agree. I agree with you.
Right.
I agree with you. It's beyond insane. It's beyond insane that he doesn't have a job because of this situation.
Right. But Ray Lewis is telling him
Hold on. But I'm not going to act like he doesn't have a job because of this situation. And neither is Ray. I'm not going to do that. Racism still exists. The white folks are making this decision.
Right.
They have the power to because the league is run by them. So you want everybody that looks like Colin Kaepernick to say, you know what, I'm going to kneel. You want everybody to have this shitstorm to deal with because of something that he was convicted to do?
I just think at the end of the day, man, it's so sad, this whole story. But for him to suppress, you know, his thoughts about what's going on in this country and has gone on in this country for
tragedy.
The last 4 or 5 years.
It's a tragedy.
It's unbelievable,
it's
man.
It's longer than 4 or 5 years.
And Ray Lewis is basically telling him to shut up.
Black people have been getting killed unjustly longer than 4 or 5 years.
But do you get that, though? What Ray Lewis is saying is, just shut up, man. Just be quiet.
No.
At the end of the day.
No, that's the way that people want it to be interpreted. No, I don't see it that way. I just don't see what Ray's saying to Colin Kaepernick as, shut up because what you're doing is wrong. No.
Nobody ever said he said shut up because you're wrong. But Ray Lewis has said, and I'll pull it up for you when we take the one little break.
That's fine, Doug.
Ray Lewis has said, protest on your own time.
Okay.
Keep it to yourself.
Okay.
He has used those words. I don't have it in front of me. Right. I'll get it during the break.
Is the protest not why Colin Kaepernick is not working, Doug?
Yes, that may be true, but is that right or wrong?
And
if you agree that it's not wrong, then you have to agree that Ray Lewis coming on record saying he should be quiet is wrong, too.
It's terribly wrong. It's terribly wrong. It hurts my heart. But it hurts my heart every day to see what's happening in these streets, too. We can't turn a blind eye to this boy's situation. We just can't do that.
Right.
His actions and what he's decided to do, rather noble, rather great, rather stupid. I know how I feel about it. You know how I feel about it. Was he right? Yes, he's got the right to do that. Should somebody do it? Yes, they should. Mm-hmm. But that's why he's not playing. Why is everybody acting like that? And if somebody tells him otherwise, they are wrong for it? I don't see it that way.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I don't know, man. Very, very, what's the word I'm looking for? Intriguing debate. Yeah.
It's easy for everybody to say what this kid should do or shouldn't be doing, man. It's very easy. Only one person gonna pay his bills. Only one person gonna pay his bills. And I think Ray is just saying, man, you need to get back to where you can get to that $20 million that you gave away, that $40 million you gave away.
Ron, you think Colin Kaepernick will play football this year?
I do not. I think he's done.
Ryan Tannehill got hurt this morning.
Right.
So, inevitably, after this show is done, I'm sure we're going to be able to turn on the Puppet Factory, which is ESPN. And to the degree Ryan Tannehill's injury is, there's going to be speculation about the Dolphins probably picking up Kaepernick.
Every team that loses a quarterback will deal with the same storyline.
I don't think he's going to get picked up.
I don't either.
And that's bullshit.
Okay.
I mean, Colin Kaepernick is better than 99% of backup quarterbacks in the NFL.
He's better than every backup.
He's better than probably a third, the bottom third. I'd say that at least.
He's better than every backup.
He's better than the bottom third of quarterbacks in the NFL right now.
He's better than every backup, man.
So this whole thing is just sad, man.
Doug, I'm willing to bet that he's better than half of the starters.
Right. I said the bottom third,
Half of the starters. If given the opportunity, if he was allowed to learn the system, he would probably be a top 10 quarterback in this league.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But I'm not going to act like if the man has decided he's not going to play no more because it's their league to make those decisions, I'm not going to act like I don't understand. I get it, and so do y'all.
Yeah.
I get it, and so do y'all.
I just think it's incredibly bad,
man,
for somebody with that microphone in front of them,
man, I'm sorry,
to put down Colin Kaepernick.
I think that words are being mixed.
And you can imagine.
And I think that y'all know for a fact that Ray Lewis has done too much for his people to be called a coon. I'm sorry.
Well, I wouldn't call him that. Never called him that.
I'm talking about words that's been used. That's all.
Right.
Yeah, I'm talking about words that's been used.
I only saved that term for certain people like Stacey Dash and Jason Whitlock.
Fat Fedora wearing. Yeah, and we got a lot of stuff to get into, man, on the back half of the show, but I just think that words are being mixed. That's all, man. And people want to villainize somebody. Yeah, I
shouldn't have said that bullshit, though.
Okay, hey, man.
Simple as that.
I support Colin Kaepernick and what he's doing, and I'll keep him in my prayers.
All right, when we get back from the break, man, a quick little break here. The Ron Stewart Show on the Two Live Shoes Radio Network. I know where this is going to go, man, but Michael Jordan had some comments about who he'd rather have, Michael or Kobe Bryant or LeBron James. And my brother's the ultimate Laker hater. It should be interesting. Don't go away. Back in 3 minutes, the Ron Stewart Show.